Hey guys, welcome back to Warren Mechanics. Thank you guys for watching and subscribing to the channel. Today will be super helpful video to any of you guys having a Hyundai. It could be multiple Hyundai models, guys. And if you need to remove steering wheel buttons for the cruise control radio or the trip reset buttons, guys, any of those buttons, stay with us. We'll explain how to do that step by step. It takes a lot of work, but it's doable. Now, I will recommend, okay, if you're not qualified and you're not certified to work on airbags, don't do it, guys. Only if you're qualified and certified to work on something like that, and you still need to know quite a bit, guys. So consider this entertaining video, not a how-to video. We'll explain what to do and what not to do. Make sure you stay until the end. Before we start, let me tell you a little bit about us. Every single car we get at the garage, we try to make at least 200 to 300 free repair videos. Why we do all that? Because our mission in the shop is to save you as much money as we can. All we need, guys, in return, please subscribe to the channel, like the video, that way we can keep making these absolutely free videos. If you need to buy any parts, tools for a good price and quick shipping, check out, guys, the link in the description of the video below. Let's go ahead and start on it now. Let's go ahead and explain now, guys, okay, how to remove Hyundai steering wheel airbag. First, you need to make sure the car battery is disconnected for at least 1 hour before the repair, guys. So now we had the charger earlier on the battery, but the battery is disconnected, so I recommend not to have chargers or anything like that close to it. So we'll disconnect everything, okay. The battery needs to be disconnected from the car. I recommend both clamps. Now let it sit for at least 1 hour, then you can continue with the next step. So it's been an hour, guys. Now we're going to go ahead and show you how to do that. This is the steering wheel airbag. So if you look at it, guys, if you have one of those, okay, it's not too complicated at all. Now, what you need to do first, okay, you need to turn the steering wheel that way, right here. Okay, let me get another person to come help quick, okay, so we can do it efficiently. You need to make sure somebody's holding the airbag so it doesn't fall off. Right here we have a small hole that you get a Phillips screwdriver, push in, and one person, okay, will pull out, okay, at the same time on this side. Okay, 1 second, not yet. Push it in a little bit. I'll push the thing in and then we pull it out. You can all yank it out, okay, by pulling on it. Now on this side there is another thing, okay, it releases the airbag on each side. Now we have one more on this side, guys, okay, perfect. Now be here very careful, okay, don't have any, okay, open electric sources, anything like that on the back side. That's your airbag, guys, okay, right here. Make sure you have somebody to support it quick, okay. Never use any metal prying tools or anything like that, only plastic tools if you need to pry something. The wires, okay, you practically pull that thing and then you disconnect the wire. The same thing occurs for the other one, okay, and it comes out here, okay. We have a clip, okay, and that clip, okay, I need to get a small screwdriver, okay, or just open it. Here is the believe the horn, and this is, guys, your airbag. That's how you remove it. Putting it together, it's pretty simple, guys. Install everything, okay, and make sure you, if you had exploded airbag, you need to inspect the system, you need to replace wirings, you need to replace the coax spring as well. Once you guys remove the airbag now, okay, right here, you can see that those switches actually attach with a screw on the back side. Okay, so let's go ahead and find the exact size. It's a Phillips screwdriver. So let's go ahead. Okay, remove that screw now. This is for the volume button. The other one, the cruise control, will practically be exactly the same. Okay, let's see if it looks like it's coming out, guys, okay. 1 second. Now that cover, okay, there is a trick here, guys, okay, that cover is about to come out on this side, but it's possible that you have more underneath, okay. So once you remove the airbag, you can continue with the steering wheel removal now, and right here you hold it, okay. I would recommend to center it so later, okay, you don't confuse it where exactly install it. Always find the torque specs for your specific car, guys, okay, to make sure that actually, okay, you get it tight enough and see if the bolt needs to be replaced. Sometimes it needs to, so I would recommend to always bring it to the middle. Go ahead, remove the nut. Now here we need to disconnect, okay, from the coax spring. That's the main wire for the steering wheel. The other one is for the airbags. It will stay there. Now you might need to shake it a little bit, guys, okay. It may be stuck a little bit. It's made to wear, okay. careful, airbag wires, to where it gets stuck a little bit, okay, perfect. And the steering wheel, okay, came out just like that. The screw that we removed earlier, guys, it's still there, so let's go ahead and remove that one. We have a few more after that. Okay, you can see one more over here. We'll need to remove that, and let's see. Okay, if that cover will be able, okay, to come out some, or if it has some screws here in the corners. Wait a minute. We need to see if we have anything, okay, here holding. So we need to actually inspect to make sure that this cover can come out, okay, and see, okay, what else we need to do, because right here I can see that there is probably only clips going in, okay, on one side. So that's what we'll be doing next. So we'll gently pry, okay, pry up. Now careful with the cables, you might need to disconnect them. Okay, let's see now here what we have. We have a clip on the bottom probably holding somewhere as well, and one on the other side too, okay, just like that, you can see. And now the only thing that we have is the wires here holding in place and the switches. Okay, let's disconnect those wires quick. Let's just pull them out and see if they can come out. Perfect, one is coming out. Now, on this side, we have another clip, wire here comes down, comes out of here, okay, and that cover came out just like that. So now if you need to remove the cruise control or steering wheel, any switch, guys, all we have to do is just unscrew now on behind the thing. You can see you have a couple screws here, okay, one over there as well. Now let's see, this one is for the, this should be for the cruise control at that point, okay. Probably we need to disconnect it only, okay, and let's see if they come together. I don't think they do. It just stuck, guys. Okay, this switch has so much, okay, probably spilled stuff. Okay, it's coming out. You just grab it, okay, and it comes out. Cruise control switch like that. If you need to remove the other one on the bottom, let me show you what you need to do. Right here, one screw. Let's do that now. So you know, guys, what to expect. That's for all the switches on the left side of the steering wheel. The one for the radio, okay, will be exactly the same as well. So this one, it will come out. Okay, let's see if we can, we need to push it, okay, over here now. On the inside. Let's check if we have anything else holding here, because it needs to come out. Okay, so if we mess up our car, we will mess it up, so that way you don't have to do yours. Now let's go ahead and pry right there in the corner, maybe. Yep, push down a little bit on this side. It comes out, it just stuck. Okay, 1 second. Let me see now what's happening. It looks like something's still holding here. So I just wonder, okay, if we need to actually, guys, remove it this way first. Check it out, to the outside comes. Perfect, so we don't, that way you don't need to pry anything. Okay. Let's see now. It's still not coming out. That's crazy, like almost halfway out right now. So no, let's see what else is holding there. That's why you should watch until the end, guys, so you don't mess it up. You don't need to do anything else once you remove the screw, but you need to separate right here that trim piece from the steering wheel. Okay, you have multiple clips, so if you get a prying tool, it will be better than a screwdriver. Okay, now that's a parts car and we're being a little bit lazy here, but it has a couple clips. All you have to do is just push it down. Okay, I got it. Now you pull it out and it comes out just like that. That's your switch, guys. Okay, you can see what we have to do. Okay, now disconnect it. So this one, you have the little tooth right here, so just pull on it, or let's probably get a little bit smaller screwdriver. That's a little bit scary. Okay, and it came out. At that point, if you need to replace the switch, all we have to do Okay, you can see it comes with that thing. That's how you guys, okay, practically do it. And if you need to pull it out, okay, you can just go in an angle and pull it out. Hopefully the video will be helpful. Thank you for watching and see you guys next time.